Hello and welcome to Faith Week. All week long, we're going to be talking about faith. You can't start talking about faith, though, without going to Hebrews chapter 11. Hebrews chapter 11 is actually known as the faith chapter, the hall of faith, the hall of heroes. And in Hebrews, he goes through talking about almost every single Old Testament patriarch, every hero that had ever been, anyone who'd ever had faith in the midst of a trial. And he starts out by saying, now then, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. What did he hope for? Well, when you get to reading in here, he tells us that by faith, in the next verse, he starts telling us that by faith, we believe that the entire world was just spoken to existence by God's spoken word, by nothing that was already in existence, but he just spoke it and there it happened. And from there on, he starts talking about Cain and Abel, and he starts going on and talking about Noah and Moses, and starts talking about their great faith and the things that they did for God because they longed for something else. They longed for heaven. They longed for that hope that was not of this world. In fact, he even tells us that they died in their faith. They died believing, even though they hadn't seen it, they died believing that it was going to happen. And still to this day, we are thousands of years later, and here we are still hoping and longing for that same thing. Our faith is still very much alive because as we have seen the Old Testament, the New Testament, the book of Revelation coming to pass right before our eyes, we are seeing the truth of the gospel coming to light, and we still have that hope and that longing today. Now think about it. If faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen, it must be a matter of where we put the object of that faith. So many of us are so wrapped up in us. We use that faith to believe for our healings. We use that faith to believe, and you should. But we have a hope that's not of this world. Those are temporary things, my friend. The Bible tells us that we're all going to die, so believing for a healing is so superficial when we can be believing for the lost loved ones to come in, when we can be believing for our churches to be filled with people who are hungry and anticipating God's return just like we are. Our faith is so shallow sometimes, though we're so simple-minded, we think of ourselves. It's time to quit thinking of us and start thinking of eternal things. It's time for us to get a little excited about going home. It's time for us to get a little excited about our faith and putting our object and trust of our faith in just Jesus Christ. The people and the heroes of the Hall of Faith, they weren't believing for superficial things. No, these people that he is talking about in Hebrews chapter 11, these were people who were life changers. I mean, Noah, 8 people gets on an ark and it saves the whole entire world. Moses led his entire people out. Joseph says, hey, don't leave my bones even behind. I'm going with you. You see, here's what we find when we start studying Hebrews chapter 11. We find real heroes, people who are willing to die for their faith. People are willing to become martyrs for their faith. This is the kind of people that we find, heroes. That's what God defines as a hero and someone who he's coming back after him. Not someone who's self-centered and believing for foolish things or believing for selfish things. And they're two different things, by the way. But God is coming back for someone who loves him, who is anxiously awaiting his appearing, and who really believes in that hope of heaven. That's who he's coming back after, my friend. So if your object of your faith is misplaced, don't be surprised if your prayers aren't answered. Just a thought. Put your faith, your hope, your trust in Jesus Christ. And then you will be able to say, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, but the evidence of things not seen. See, it's a manner of where we put our hope. If we transfer our hope toward heaven, everything begins to change. Yes, God will answer our prayers, and we'll be talking more about that later on this week. But really, Hebrews chapter 11 is more about where our hope is. But see, God will promise us that he will take care of us no matter what. He said he'd never leave us. He said he'd never forsake us. He said that he would be with us. He would stick close to us. You never have to worry about how close God's going to be if we'll get close to him. Draw yourself close to God. Let him feel your power and your love today in his life. And I promise you, he'll return that right back to you, because when you give everything to God, he gives everything right back to you. He is an awesome God. Amen. God bless you. Have a great week. Don't forget to click share and send this video out to somebody else. Let them know that their substance of their faith can be met through God, and he can change lives and he can transform them through the power of his spoken word. God bless you and have a terrific day.